Good morning, students of class 10. All of you are welcome back to the online portal now. Let us begin our lesson in history. The rise of nationalism in Europe. This is the chapter. Now we have reached the last portion. Today we will do conclusion 6.0. We can go to that point. Nationalism and imperialism. This is the subtitle, and we are doing the last paragraph, the conclusion of the whole chapter. So now here, there are altogether 5 points to remember. What are those 5 points in the conclusion overall? Now here, we have seen nationalism spread all over Europe, and there were imperialism also. So nationalists oppose the policies and the rule by the imperialist, and ultimately they were successful to secure their country as nation states. And we have learned about the First World War of 1914. It is all about these conflicts between the nationalist and the imperialist. Now here, number one, first point, many countries in the world which had been colonized by the European powers. The European powers had colonized practically most part of the world in the 19th century. Even our country, India, was colonized during 19th century and began to oppose the people around the world, native people around the world. They started opposing the colonizers, oppose imperial dominations, European dominations, or colonizers, you can say that. They started opposing these Europeans, number one. Number two, around the world during 19th century. Number two, the anti-imperial movements. Anti means against. People, they formed associations, they formed movements, and they started opposing anti-imperial movements that developed everywhere, not in one section or not one part of the world. In every part of the world, the nationalist feelings is spread from Europe to all parts of the world. We have seen in before, we have learned before, that developed everywhere were nationalist. All the people who opposed the imperials or the colonizers, these people were nationalist, and they struggled to form independent nation states. They struggled. Many of them, thousands of them, laid down their lives. They sacrificed their lives to form a nation state, independent country. Freedom doesn't come just like that. You have to pay the price. And the price was paid by the people, by sacrificing their lives, many of them. It doesn't come just like that. So nationalists and struggle, these nationalists, the people around the colonies, native people around the colonies in the world, they struggled to form independent nation states, and they had paid a huge price for that. They were inspired, encouraged, inspired, INSPIRED, they were inspired by a sense of collective national unity. Freedom just cannot, you cannot fight for freedom alone. You need to unite together. Sense of collective national unity, you can see the national unity have to be made. That's why in India also, Rajaram Mohan Roy and many social reformers, they try to unite the people. So similarly, around the world, in the colonies, the native people, they were inspired by the sense of collective national unity forged means combined, in confrontation. Confrontation means to come face to face with the imperialism. These nationalists, or they can say the native people around the colonies, they came face to face with the imperialist. They had to face. So they were inspired by this sense of collective national unity. They have seen what happened in European countries, how France was France fought with the imperialist, how France became an independent country, and other European countries such as Germany, Italy. So how they became independent country. So these lessons inspired them to have a sense of collective national unity and fight for freedom against the imperialist, or can say the colonizers. European ideas, of course, the ideas came from Europe. Liberty, sovereignty, socialism, everything came from abroad, from outside. European ideas of nationalism were not replicated. Replicate means copied blindly. They were not replicated. Replicated means copied blindly by people everywhere. The idea was there, but the idea was modified according to their needs, according to the situation. They did not copy blindly everywhere, but they developed their own specific variety of nationalism. The idea was there, but they have modified their ideas, implemented according to suit their country and the people, and developed a specific variety of nationalism. Nationalism, the idea was there from Europe, but around the colonies in the world, around the world, people have developed this nationalism according to the need of their place and the country, and develop a variety of nationalism. But the idea remains the same. But the idea that society should be organized, should be united into nation states, to form nation states, came to be accepted as natural and universal. So this, but the idea that societies should be organized national unity, you can say collective national unity, organized into nation states to form or create a nation state or an independent state. To form that independent states, people have to be united and they have to struggle together. And came to be accepted, all the people, they accepted this idea. You have to sacrifice, you have to struggle, you have to unite in order to form the nation state. You cannot form a nation state without these things. It came to be accepted as natural and universal. We are born free and we need to fight for freedom. Otherwise, you will be dominated by the powerful. So people have accepted these ideas of nationalism, how it emerged in Europe and how it spread all over the world. They got the ideas and modified that ideas according to suit their needs, and specific variety of nationalism emerged all over the colonies, and one by one they became independent states, nation states. They got their rights, they got their liberty, sovereignty, socialism, everything spread around the world in colonies. So that's the end of the chapter. We have come to the end of the chapter, and in our next class we'll have to continue a new chapter, nationalism in Indochina. We'll talk about Indochina. It's also another story about nationalism. the people having the feeling of nationalism in Indochina. Why that area is called Indochina? A lot of things are there to learn in our next class. So we'll learn about the nationalist movement in Indochina next chapter in our next class. All of you must pay attention and be attentive and must be present for the classes. So that's all for today. Thank you very much for watching so attentively, paying so much attention, listening carefully and being present in the class with me. Thank you very much. You must be present in our next class as well. So thank you very much for listening.